out of bounds, and it's going to be White. Cannot be controlled by Southridge. So on the attack, Dubois with it, Schoate. Schoate to the right side to Canese. Out front is Darren Cave. Cave off left side to Schoate. Schoate now to England, deep in the corner, back out to Schoate. Top of the key goes to Cave. Cave goes right side to Canese. Underneath, off left side, 20. It's Schoate. Schoate scans one from 20 feet, and he draws first blood. It's 2-0 as the Northeast Dubois Jeep. But the first 2 points on the board. Barnett moves across the line. Out front it comes to Park. Park goes deep left side. Now they'll move inside, and a little stutter step there against the Southridge Raiders. Well, Noss has quickly come out of the ball game. And we'll check to see the insertion. I still have number 52 for Noss. Dubois on the attack. Right side, Cave, cross court pass, deep in the corner, goes to Schoate. And all right, Ted O'Brien, who we didn't have written on the program, has been inserted into the lineup now in place of Nas. Dubois inbounds the ball, out front to Cave, goes left side, now back out front, goes to Schoate. Schoate moves the top of the key, sets up the offense, goes left side, Cave, out front to Schoate again, now deep on the right side. Comes off. Cross court pass to Cave. Cave gets rid of the ball. Back out front to Schoate. Schoate now comes near side to Dwayne Canese. Canese holds the ball high over his head, tries to jam one in, but it's kicked out of bounds by one of the Raiders. As Hilfsmeyer was blocking. Tried to get that pass in to John Schoate. He was beneath the basket. Well, it looks like the Jeeps are going to play a little pattern ball and just go for that inside man if they can get him. Ball inbounded. Comes in to Canese, who's at the top of the key. Almost a bad pass, but Schoate gathers it in. Now comes over to Cave. Cave goes left side. Canese. Schoate deep in the right corner. They're not even looking at that basket. Cave with a basketball now. Back to Schoate near side. Along the baseline. Up with the shot. England cans it. Two field goals now for Dubois. They lead it 4-0. As England and Schoate have scored, and it's 4-0. The Jeeps on top of Southridge here on the Holiday Tournament Consolation Round. Bob Boyles along with Al Pillsbury and Walt Ferber. Right side, Southridge, Olinger. Olinger comes near side to Park on the deep and left corner. Back out front, they go to Hilfsmeyer. Hilfsmeyer, right side now. Barnett, top the key, has the ball intercepted on a bad pass. And here comes the Jeeps. Jeeps driving down the lane. And Schoate goes up and he'll be hammered. Schoate was cut off by Tom Barnett. And that'll be the first personal foul called against Tom Barnett. Kelly Olinger has picked up one, so that's the second team foul.
Barnett getting a hold of the ball, two arms, part of the body, and bringing it all down to the floor.
Well, it's decidedly taller than Schoate, but Schoate stayed right with him. Schoate has a field goal. Now he has a free throw, making 3 points, and it's a five-point lead for Dubois. In fact, it's 5-0. Coach Duncan still sitting passively on the bench as he watches the second one drop through. Schoate now at 4 points and a 6-0 lead all of a sudden for Northeast Dubois. Here comes Southridge on the attack. Barnett, top of the circle, moves left side, passes off to Park. Park, right-hand side, goes to Hilfsmeyer, deep in the right corner. Shot put up and good by Tom Barnett. So Southridge finally, with 5 minutes and 25 seconds left on that clock here in the first quarter, cans their first basket, cuts the 6-point lead down to 4 at 6-2. Here are the Jeeps with the basketball. Canese, right side. Inside it goes to Englert. Englert, a turnaround shot, no good. Rebound ripped down by Southridge. Here comes Park. Park got the rebound. Hands off to Barnett, who just canned that last field goal last time down. Barnett moves over to the right side, deep in the right corner. We go to Hilfsmeyer. Top the key comes Park. Park will try to set it up. Moves right side to Hilfsmeyer. Hilfsmeyer has to come back out front to Barnett. Now deep in the left corner, bobbles the ball, but gathers it back in and throws it back to Barnett. Now they go right side to Hilfsmeyer. Hilfsmeyer to Olinger. Olinger holds the ball high over his head, has to come back outside. Nice defense put up by the Dubois Jeeps. Here's a shot put up long way out by Hilfsmeyer Camden, and it's a 6-4 ball game. The 6-0 lead now diminishes just to 2 as Southridge, with Hilfsmeyer and Barnett, a whole new five starting here in this ball game. Actually, they needed the basketball. They wanted Knopf to get the tip, which he didn't, incidentally. And O'Brien came in. So we got five players that didn't start last night. Darren Cave gets a good pass, goes left side upwards, and good. Darren Cave gets his first field goal, and it's 8-4. Here come the Raiders. Two boys lead by the 4 points. Go down to the left side. It's O'Brien, and we've got a three-second violation called against the Southridge Raiders. That'll be the second turnover, I believe, for Southridge. Kind of shooting we got going over here, Al. Two out of two for the Raiders from the floor, and for Northeast Dubois, three out of four. Four turnovers for Southridge, no turnovers for the Jeeps. All righty, 8-4 is our score with 3:42 to go here in the first quarter. The Jeeps have the four-point lead. They've got the basketball, and now it's batted away from them quickly by Barnett. He'll go to the basket and has it knocked out of bounds. It'll still belong. Game. Darren Cave with the basketball. You see from he's way out on the left side. Comes to the top of the key to Dwayne Canese. Underneath they go to Englert. He'll drive the lane up with it good. Englert gets his second field goal, and it's a 12-6 basketball game. Dubois has the lead by 6 points, 2:13 to play in the first quarter. Hilsmeyer for Southridge has it. He'll move it over to the left side, goes to Barnett. Back to Barnett, the shot up and good. Barnett, his second field goal. Southridge, a real ragged start. They were down 6-0 to start. Kept the lead down to 2 when it was 6-4. Got down by 6 again at 12-6. Now it's got a 4-point deficit they're looking at. With a minute 50 to play, 12-8. The Jeeps with the basketball. They ram it inside and up with the shot. Well, the shot's no good, but a foul will be called. Well, the difference, 4 points. Right there. Here's the shot put up by the Jeeps. Canning it is Bob Stefanaga. Stefanaga really hadn't touched the basketball all that much. He stretches the lead to 5, misses this one, however, and the rebound is easily pulled down by the Raiders. Here they come. Phil Park comes down the left side, moves to the top of the circle. Tom Barnett, bad pass, and it's going to go out of bounds. A little mix-up between two Raider players over in the corner. Harmlessly up into the air, and we've got a total of seven turnovers. That won't buy you very many basketball games. 13-8, the 5-point lead belongs to Dubois, and here they come. Darren Cave has it. Cave shot a couple of times, was able to can one. Lady score last night he had 13 points. Here they try to jam one inside to Stephen to play in the first quarter. Dubois with the basketball, and they're into the court. Inside, it goes to Cave. He'll take the shot in the corner, no good. Ball saved inbounds by Stefanaga, but right into the hands of Southridge is Phil Park. Park will slow it down, and he'll move to the left side. The jam one inside goes into Yoakum. Yoakum tosses the ball, tries to hit.
Here's a couple of critical free throws. Coach Duncan would be happy with just one, and Mike Hilfmeyer is the man on the bubble right now. The shot up. Hilfmeyer, Kansas. That's the first time he's been to the line. He has 5 points, a field goal in the first quarter and in the third quarter, and he has stretched the lead to three now for Southridge. He got the hard one. Now we'll see this one. 47-43, 14 seconds to go. If he doesn't, Katie barred the door. Second one drops through. It just dropped back, I would imagine. 13 seconds, the clock going. Schott with it. He'll move left side. He goes inside, up off the glass. It's no good. He can't get it, and a foul call in deep. And they were. We have only 5 seconds left, and Hilfmeyer will step back up again. He calmly arches this one high, and it drops right through. It's 49-44. Southridge from the championship round via the overtime route. They didn't want to get back into it. Here's another shot. It's good by 50-44. The Raiders will just drop back. Only 4 seconds. They'll let Engler drive unmolested into the lane up with a shot.